Today, what I want to do is take this trichoderma that I have right here in this plate, which came from a tree in my grove. We know it's endophytic, and we know this particular tree has handled some water well, relatively well. So it is a very important trichoderma for me to preserve now. So I don't like the way it sporulates. It's not very strong on PDA with antibiotics. So what I want to do a pure liquid culture of it to do two things, to propagate and to inject in the grain bag. And also because I want to save some of it in my refrigerator so it could be used at a future time. And by the way, these are skills that growers of medium to large size should be learning. Not sure if the extensions, agricultural extensions, should be involved in this, universities or high schools. I mean, this is the future, biological controls that you pick from your own soil, that you know that they have worked, and then you reapply them into the soil. First of all, you have control over the whole operation. It doesn't need a lot of equipment. And you're saving a lot of money because you're getting, first of all, you're making the biocontrols yourself, and you're also making them very clean. A lot of the biocontrols, with very few exceptions that you get, sometimes, especially trichodermas, come contaminated with other stuff. So let's make the liquid culture. To make the liquid media, we start with 250 milliliters of distilled warm water. We already pre-measured 5 grams of potato dextrose broth powder and about 1.5 grams of honey. This will make a very nice liquid culture, but if you don't have potato dextrose broth, you can follow any recipe for liquid culture that online from most of the people that are online talking about how they grow mushrooms. The liquid culture that they use works with trichodermas as well. So we put this in here. We put the magnetic stirrer. We put it in the stir plate and we mix. You put one of these lids. You could get online many different variations of it. Mushroom growing supply outfits, etc. And as you could see, it makes a very, very clear broth to cultivate your trichodermas. Very nice. Now this goes in the pressure cooker for about 20, 25 minutes to get sterilized. Now it's time to inoculate the liquid culture, and we have several ways of doing it. We can put a piece from the petri dish in here, or we can do a wash of mycelium and spores and inject it without having to open it. But since I want to save this for future use, I'm going to do a wash, and then I'm going to inject here, and then I'm going to put some in these vials with a solution of 50% glycerol, which is this product here, and 50% sterilized water, and this all gets placed in the pressure cooker to sterilize. So we're going to do it this way. This is fresh out of the sterilizer. This is sterilized water. Some here.
see how it comes right off, and it becomes a suspension. Not a lot, because this Trichoderma is not sporulating a lot, but you can see the green spores and the mycelium getting mixed nicely. The solution will shrink. Here it is. We got like 7 cc's, which is plenty. By the color of it, you could see it's got enough. So what we're going to do, we're going to put some in here. That should be enough. One cc here, one cc there. Then we're going to put the glycerol. Now these will go in the refrigerator inside a jar, and you can establish new plates with just a drop of these, or even less, just a tiny little touch. This is how a 10-day-old culture looks. It's pretty much full, except that it's got a little bit of a clear fluid on top, which is good to examine because we might make sure that it's very clear, like this, you see? Extremely clear, so there's no bacteria, just full of mycelium. This is enough to inoculate a lot of bags. This one is a little bit more liquid, less mycelium, but they're all different. This is a slow-moving Trichoderma. You could clearly see it. Very nice. Now, the next step is stir for a while so we can break up the mycelium, so we can extract the amounts that we need to inoculate the bags. So we already got like probably 11 cc's here. And we just simply take this. Never hold it from here because it will leak. Just hold it from here. And it's basically done. You got enough liquid here to do 10, 15, 20 of these bags. So now what I am going to do is I'm going to inoculate another bag. We are going to do the second bag. Again, straight to the refrigerator, and in case we need to do more bags, so we do two bags of this, and we should have some activity very soon.
There has been now 7 days since we finished inoculating these bags. Some of them, and I did like 5 different trichodermas, some of them are getting very green. They're almost ready in another day or two. How can you tell? It's because if you see the spores coming loose and you put this back to the light, you will see there is a lot of spores. Others just turn very green and don't shed the spores that easily. So the next step is going to be to take some of these bags to the grove. And I will show you how I wash the grain and put it through the irrigation system, which is the way I do it. From this stage on, there are many different ways you as a grower can do to use your own grain-grown trichoderma. I may want to add at this point that trichodermas are all different. You could find Trichoderma harsianum, two or different strains of the same trichoderma, and they will behave totally different, will react different, depending on the grain that you use. So it's becoming a learning experience to learn what each ones of the ones that I use like to do and will make my work easier. We're gonna start with the process of washing the grain. These bags are fully colonized. They're in great condition. So we are going to start the washing process, cutting the bag. I always like to wash the bag because it's got a tremendous amount of spores. Just a little bit there. And this is amazing. Look, just from the spores in the bag, look at the color. Billions of spores. Just from the bag alone. I think I'm gonna do two bags at the same time to save time. Amazing color. Do the same thing, wash the bag. Some of this water with the polysorbate. And we start the washing process.
This cannot be any greener. This is going to make a very dark 35-45 gallon inoculum. Now I will start with the 600, then the 400, the 200, and the 100 before putting it into the tank. So we go with the 600. This is very green. Notice this. This is where the clean water line is. Right now, you could hardly see it. It's about here. And you will see how the color starts changing and how thick it gets with the Trichoderma wash that we are going to put in here. We add water to facilitate spreading the liquid over a period of longer period of time. Look at the mark now. This is a 35-gallon mark. And we have an inoculum, very, very dark green. Probably we'll be looking at 1 times 10 to the 9th or to the 10th power per milliliter of liquid.